Surgical mask original or duplicate. Here I am explaining three simple home experiments to determine the surgical mask now available, whether they are original or duplicate. So here we have taken two surgical masks. These have been brought from two different shops and we are trying to find out which is original and which is duplicate. For this, first we are cutting the surgical mask with a scissor, and as we all know, the surgical mask has three layers. We cut it open with scissors and we are going to take out the middle one, the middle layer, and we are showing this middle layer near a lighted candle. So let's wait and see what is happening. So as we can see, the number one mask that is starting burning. Slowly and slowly it catches fire and starts burning. But the number two mask, as we can see, is only melting. From one end it keeps on melting and melting. So this proves that the mask which is catching fire and burning, that is a duplicate one. The original mask never burns, it only melts, slowly melts till the end. There are two types of fabrics. First one is the woven one and second is the melt blown one. As we can see, the woven fabric includes cotton, linen, silk, all this, which catches fire easily. The second one is melt blown one, which is made up of polypropylene. This is the one which is used commonly for making the surgical mask. This is only having a pore size of 3 microns and it only melts on showing to the candle. As we can see, the cough droplets, RBCs, all this get easily filtered by the surgical mask. But even though the aerosols have a very small size compared to the others, get entrapped inside the mask by its adsorption property. So as we know, the coronavirus, who have also known to have an aerosol spread, also gets filtered via this surgical mask. So the nearby picture shows how this particles has been entrapped by electrostatic adsorption inside the mask hole. In the second experiment, we have taken small paper pieces which mimics the aerosol, and we can clearly see a good quality mask absorbs the paper while the other one doesn't. Next, we are testing the water repellents. As we can see, here all the good quality mask will have excellent water repellent property. Here, I have kept water droplets over the outside layer of both the mask using a water dropper. And as we can see, both the masks showed good repellents. After 20 minutes, the water had trickled the number one mask and wet the tissue paper below. But in the second one, water droplets remained as such, ensuring the good quality. So, concluding, the number two mask who passed all the three experiments is the original one, and the number one who failed all the three is a duplicate and won't serve the purpose.